Friends, let's see today's lovely recipe of donuts. This is a super simple recipe. So let's go through the ingredients. Here is one egg. This is 2 1/4 cup or 295 grams of maida or all-purpose flour. This is 3 tablespoons or 35 grams of sugar, 1 1/2 teaspoon of dry yeast, 1/2 teaspoon of vanilla essence, and 3 tablespoons or 40 grams of butter, and 1/2 cup or 120 ml of milk. Now you get this donut, mold, or you can use your imagination and just take a bigger round circle and a smaller round circle if you don't have this mold and cut out the shapes. Now the first most important point is we're going to add the flour and the yeast together. And we're going to mix the yeast and the flour really well together. And then we're going to add the butter. Now we're going to mix all of these ingredients very well till it resembles some bread crumbs. Now this is a very important step. Take about 2 to 3 minutes, but see that all of the flour is coated very well with the butter. Now we're going to add the powdered sugar. Now here I have one egg which I'm just going to beat, and I'm going to add the vanilla essence to it. Now for some reason my camera just didn't shoot the next step, so please bear with me, but you have to make this well in the middle of the flour and add your egg and the milk too. And then you'll get a consistency like this. I'm really sorry for that. I think I forgot to turn my camera on, or the camera, I don't know just what happened. Please bear with me on this. I'm really sorry for that. But you just have to add your egg, beaten egg and milk, and just knead this dough till it becomes nice and firm. Now we're just going to knead the dough really well on a surface. This is also very important if you want to have lovely, light, fluffy donuts. Now I'm just going to cut the shapes out, and I've lined my baking tray with some baking paper. We're not going to be baking these donuts, although I will come up with a recipe of baked donuts soon. So I'm just going to keep taking out the donut shapes, and I'm going to just lay them on this baking paper, and I'm going to do the same with the rest of the flour. So you can make as many as you want for that particular day, or you can just, store the rest in your refrigerator for a day or two. And now I am just going to place them on that baking tray, and I'm going to cover this, and I'm going to keep this for about 6 to 7 hours till they completely rise. Now you can also do this in the night and keep it overnight, or in the afternoon, keep it for the entire evening or whatever. Just work it out that way. But keep it for at least 6 to 7 hours, and then you will see that they really double in size like this. And now all we have to do is just chuck them into some hot oil and fry them till they're light golden brown in color. Now you have to keep an eye on them. You can't let them just fry because they turn golden brown instantly. So keep your kitchen tissue or your kitchen napkins ready, because we want to soak the, get all the excess oil out. And fry them till they're golden brown, and then just keep them on your tissue on your tissues or your napkins. Yes, friends, I will come out with a baked version very soon. Just give me a few days more. And in this way, you can fry all of them. Now, I've got some powdered sugar ready. So as they are, they're hot, just dip them into that powdered sugar. I'm going to show you 3 ways of how you can keep your donuts. One is just the simple donuts. Many people like to just dip them into their coffee and have them simple and plain like this, just out of the oil, drain all the oil out, let them come to room temperature, and then just dunk them into some hot coffee. The other way is you just put it into some powdered sugar and have it that way. And the third way is, I think most people love it that way, is dipping it into some chocolate. So in this way, just fry them, but just keep an eye on them because they turn golden brown almost instantly. Now, you can either, you know, melt your chocolate like I did on a double boiler. I just took some dark chocolate compound and I melted it on a double boiler. Double boiler is just to keep a vessel filled with water down and then keep a glass bowl, preferably a microwave proof bowl, on top. Put your dark chocolate into it and let the chocolate melt. And then I just added about, like I took about half a cup of chocolate, dark chocolate compound. To that, I just added about 2 tablespoons of fresh cream. I just had some fresh cream at home, or you can even use, the cream that, comes on top of the milk. You don't need to have ready-made fresh cream, just to give it that little bit of a glaze. So here I've dipped half of them into some powdered sugar. This is just plain powdered sugar. Just take some sugar and put them into your mixer or your blender and grind it to a fine powder. People who don't like chocolate might enjoy this. And this is my chocolate ganache already. That is, I just took the dark compound, melted it and added a little bit of fresh cream to get that glaze. And just dip them. Don't dip them completely. Let half of it be, like this. Just one half of chocolate and the other half plain. And you'll see that the ganache, just sets almost instantly. Now, if you don't have any dark chocolate compound at home, you can also just dip this into some chocolate syrup, like some Hershey's chocolate syrup. You can be creative with donuts. So these are so easy to make. I'm sure you're going to give it a try. Do let me know in the comment section below how your donuts turned out. I would love to hear from all of you. Thanks for watching, guys. I'll catch you soon.